Okay, welcome to this texture animator tutorial. In this tutorial we're going to cover installing the plugin and the basics, and let's get to it. Okay, these are the three packages that are available for download at Renderosity. It's texture animator underscore 32.zip. That is for 32-bit versions of the texture animator or DAZ Studio, excuse me. And the next one is texture animator 64.zip, and that is for 64-bit versions of DAZ Studio and texture animator. And the next one is texture animator underscore docs.zip, and that contains all the documentation for texture animator. Now what you want to do, there's a inside the docs folder, there's a readme underscore texture animator dot text. That's the readme file for texture animator, and in it near the top there is installation instructions. And the first thing you want to do is make sure you're logged in on it as administrator whenever you're installing a plugin. And that's because on some I believe it's Windows 8, and there's one other one, there's an issue with if you're not logged in as administrator, the plugin might get placed in the virtual store on Windows 8, and then it won't load properly. But if you're logged on as administrator, it'll install it to the correct folder and not the virtual store. That's why anytime you're installing anything, it's always good to be logged on as administrator. Anyway, so the first thing you want to do is our documentation folder zip file we downloaded. You want to extract that to your My Library folder. Okay, we'll extract the contents to the My Library folder. Just click on the Browse button, and wherever you installed your My Library folder to, it's usually My Documents, DAZ 3D, Studio, My Library. There we go. And that's the path to my where I installed My Library folder. And you click Extract. Now in this case, if the folders already exist, which the documentation folder should, it'll prompt you if you want to merge the two folders. Select Yes. And that installed our docs folder. If you need to, in the documentation folder itself, you can just double click on the readme and open it up and read the instructions too if you want. And and now the next step is install either the 32 or the 64-bit version. And if you're running the 32-bit version of DAZ Studio, use the 32-bit version of Texture Animator. If you're using the 64-bit version of DAZ Studio, install the 64-bit version. And depends on your operating. If you get a 64-bit operating system, should be using the 64-bit version of DAZ Studio and the Texture Animator. One thing to know, in DAZ Studio 4.8, IRA is only supported in 64-bit version, and it's not supported on the 32. So and if you get them mixed up, that in DAZ Studio itself, it won't load the plugin if it's the incorrect version. So if you have a problem, that to check to make sure that you extracted the right run. In this case, we're going to do the 64-bit. And you're just going to go under your computer, the root drive. The 64-bit goes to program files, and the file path if you have the default install location for DAS Studio, you only have to extract it to program files. The rest of the file paths and the zip file are already set up for it. But if you, in this case here is a DAS3D folder, is right in program files. If you installed it somewhere else, you just select that location, wherever the your DAS3D folder is for that, in this case. Then extract, same thing. It'll prompt you if you want to merge the folders. Go yes. And in this case, check down here, do this for all current items. And it's asking the same thing. If you want to merge two folders, click yes. And this little one is for the files themselves. I already have it installed, so that's why this one comes up. So copy and replace, yes. And this is, you might get this one if you need administrator permission to copy this folder. Click continue. Copy and replace. Now it's copying them over. Well, that should have been done by now, you'd think. Might have been because I had that file open. Alright. Something's not going right there. We'll do it again. Oh, I got DAS Studio open, no wonder. Plugins loaded. Make sure you got DAS Studio closed. That's why. Okay, do this again. See, my computer, see, program files for 64-bit, OK, extract, merge the folders, yes, files, continue. There we go, much more like it. Okay, now both the plugin and the documentation for the 64-bit's been installed, so load DAS Studio. And your interface is up. Now one thing to know for plugins, you can Texture Animator's been installed. You can check the installation by going under Help, About Installed Plugins, and the list of all the plugins you have installed on your system will be here. Close that one up. And it should be under T. There it is, Texture Animator plugin. And if you get the little green plug there, that means that it's loaded. And down below is a version number and description. That's how you know if it installed right. If it failed, that means the little red plug means that it probably installed the 32-bit version when you should have did a 64. Well, there is that's usually the reason why the wrong version. If that happens, just remove that one and make sure you're doing the right version. Okay, now to access the plugins interface, up here on the menu screens, you go Window, Panes, Tabs, and this is a list of all the plugins installed. You want to go down to Texture Animator and just click on it, and there the interface will appear. And I just want to grab it. Just put it wherever you want. I usually like to dock it over here on my panel next to surfaces. That's where I like putting it. So you can undock it. Make pane undockable. When you make it undockable, it'll show these the minimize tab where you can minimize it down. Maximize it don't go any good. It just keeps the interface the same size. And then if you want to redock it, you click this little tab and just put it right where you want. And now I got it kind of designed because of the shape of the interface. It works best on the side panels. You can dock it down below, but it just fits better when we're here in one of these. And that's about all there is to it. The rest of the tutorials will cover all this view help tutorials. If you want to download the tutorials from YouTube, I didn't actually put them with the, because they're all in HD format and they're quite large file size. You can go to YouTube. Here's the tutorials, maybe viewed at, and here's the URL. You can just copy. Well, let me see. Yeah, make sure I copied that. And it goes to the playlist for Texture Animator, and here you'll find the tutorials for camera switches, how to create a I covered as much as I could. Since Texture Animator renders out to image sequence, I made a little video on how to create a video from image sequences, and that's using Blender. But there's quite a few ways of doing that, but Blender is the one I like using. You can also use After Effects, or if you haven't, convert video to image sequences, rendering image sequences for using Texture Animator, renaming image sequences. That's a handy, there's a handy tool for doing that, and it's freeware. I use it a lot. It looks like it's a very complex interface, but I made a little tutorial about it. Sometimes it's handy. And yeah, if you forget to do the underscore character between the numbering system and the file name, and you have to redo it, you can use that tool. Another next tutorial is rendering your data scene using Texture Animator, and create custom textures with overlays. That's if you got overlays of bruising or something like that on your favorite character. So you're making like a Rocky-like movie or boxing movie or something, and you need to give them black eyes or something. You can use Texture Animator to change the textures, but this tutorial covers how to create them in Blender. As long as you get an overlay, you can just scale it and rotate it and put it wherever you want. It makes a great handy little tool for, in fact, I use After Effects and Blender to create my own animated textures. So, but with the overlays, I found I kind of like using Blender better. And that's just a promo video, that one. Now this one is Texture Animation Jobs, how to create, edit, load, and save them. Base opacity animations, that covers everything about that. And that's just this one down here is an overview of Texture Animator plugin. Besides though, this tutorial is going to be installing in the basics. But only the tutorials you need are right here. And at Renderosity, if you my username is Provincial, and just send me a private message, and if you have any questions or anything. Okay, so the next step, let's see, and I believe that's it for the basics. That's about it. And your best thing to do is to watch the tutorials. You learn all the features. Some of these are just step by step, and on how to do the base opacity animations, the camera switches, the rendering features, and the animation jobs. The one thing, the map model surfaces one, that's just a little utility that I created. I left it in case someone found it handy. But I kind of designed it only if there's one, if I'm working on creating animated textures for a specific model or something like that, I'll just only have that model in the scene. Is basically, and you run Map Model Services, and all the file paths to the textures and the RGB values, it records them to a text file. But it's just so you know, it's only designed for pretty much just one model in the scene. I left it in if someone might find it handy. Other than that, there's tutorials for everything else, and I believe that's about it. And I thank you for watching, and thank you for purchasing the plugin.